Hello students, I'm Dr. Himanshu Kanpal, Assistant Professor English, Government MS College for Women, Bikaner. Today we are going to start with a new poem, The Face That Launched a Thousand Ships by Christopher Marlowe. This poem is included in English Literature Syllabus, BA Part 1st of MGS University, Bikaner. First we are going to learn about the poet Christopher Marlowe. About the poet. Christopher Marlowe was a prominent English poet, playwright, and translator of the Elizabethan era. He was born in Canterbury, United Kingdom, to a wealthy shoemaker, John Marlowe. He was educated at the King's School, Canterbury, and Corpus Christi College, University of Cambridge. He was greatly influenced by Niccolò Machiavelli, Ovid, and Virgil. He introduced blank verse to English drama. Blank verse is verse which is written in unrhymed iambic pentameter lines. So he was the person to introduce blank verse to English drama, and his plays truly capture the Renaissance spirit of his times. He became popular in the literary circles with the staging of Tamburlaine the Great in 1587 in London. This pioneering blank verse play was an immediate success. His other outstanding works are a short epic poem, Hero and Leander, a lyric poem, The Passionate Shepherd to His Love, a famous tragedy, The Jew of Malta, and the tragedy of infamous Dr. Faustus, from which the present poem is an extract or taken. Christopher Marlowe died at an early age of 29, as he was killed in a drunken brawl. Marlowe was the greatest of a group of young writers, generally called the university wits, during the Elizabethan era. Before his untimely death at the age of 29, as I've told you that he was killed in a drunken brawl, he had founded English Romantic Tragedy, had written one of the greatest poetical dramas in the English language, and he converted the stiff mechanical blank verse of Gobaduck into a vital form which Shakespeare in his turn could make fit for the speeches of his greatest characters in his dramas. But we can say that Marlowe was far more than a pioneer. He shines across the centuries in the blaze of his genius. His dramas show only moderate constructive ability of or power of characterization, but they carry the reader away by the sheer force and beauty of their language and by the great visions which they call up in the mind. Now we are going to move to the interpretation of the poem, or interpreting the poem, The Face That Launched a Thousand Ships. This is just a brief note about the poem. The Face That Launched a Thousand Ships is an extract. Extract means it is taken from Christopher Marlowe's play, and we can say famous play, Dr. Faustus. This poem features in Act 5th, Scene 1st of the drama, Dr. Faustus. Dr. Faustus is a magician and doctor of medicine and divinity. Faustus has bartered his soul to the devil Lucifer in exchange for baser material pleasures of life, such as wealth, wine, women, and power. On the request of his scholar friends, Dr. Faustus revives Helen back to life. Faustus too is mesmerized. Mesmerized means he was fascinated when he sees Helen. He deeply desires to make her his paramour. So the poem begins with the scene when Faustus performs his last act of conjuring. Conjuring means caused to appear by means of magic ritual. Conjuring at the request of a friend and conjures up the image of Helen of Troy. So here we are going to learn something about who was Helen of Troy. Helen of Troy, in the classical mythology, the most beautiful woman in the world. She was a daughter of Zeus by Leda. She was abducted by Paris, that led to the Trojan War. Helen's was the face that launched 1,000 ships. It means the entire Greek army sailed to Troy to get her back. So, Helen of Troy is a character in Homer's classic epic poem, The Iliad, written in the 8th century about the Trojan War, imagined by the Greeks to have occurred about 500 years earlier. Her story is one of the most dramatic stories of all time and is said to be one of the main reasons for a 10-year war between the Greeks and the Trojans, known as Trojan War. So, hers was the face that launched 1,000 ships. Because of the vast number of warships, the Greeks sailed to try to retrieve Helen. So, Trojan War was fought between Greeks and people of Troy. The strife began when Trojan Prince Paris abducted Helen, wife of Menelaus of Sparta. So, Faustus is stunned by her beauty. He presents her as an epitome of beauty. Epitome means embodiment of beauty and the most desirable woman in the world. Faustus believes that her classical beauty can make him immortal through a kiss. He is hopeful of finding his paradise in Helen's arms. He wishes to be Paris, the Trojan prince who had invited war with Menelaus, Helen's husband, by abducting Helen. He is ready to kill even Achilles, the great Greek general, for the sake of Helen. So, here in this poem, Dr. Faustus, or we can say he was a true Renaissance icon, he craves for Helen, a classical beauty, and this poem is the lyrical expression of his feelings. In the poem, he further sings in praise of her dazzling, shining beauty and asserts that she excels Jupiter in brightness and is lovelier than the reflection of the sky falling into Lake Arethusa. He once again expresses his resolution to make her his paramour. Paramour means a lover. This 20-line poem written in blank verse is a celebrated speech of Foster's, which echoes the poetic genius of Marlowe. This is all about the poem, The Face That Launched the Thousand Ships.